Will advertisers do an about face and start yanking ads from Facebook? Or is it too big, too powerful to even consider leaving the platform? Let's hear from our panel of experts. Advertising Hall of Famer Linda Thaler, the woman behind some of the most memorable TV commercials around, including one of my favorites, I'm a Toys R Us kid, and the Affleck Duck. And in San Francisco, brand leadership expert Denise Lee Yohn, author of What Great Brands Do. Welcome, ladies, to Power Lunch. Denise, I'll kick it off to you. Do you think that Mark Zuckerberg did a sufficient job to preserve the Facebook brand in all of the interviews that he did yesterday? Or do you think advertisers could actually think, you know what, maybe we can reallocate ad dollars to another platform like a Google?
I do think we're going to see advertisers pull out of Facebook. They need to show that they are doing something, because customers these days are looking for those actions. So it's not enough for Mark to apologize and say he's going to comply with regulations. I think advertisers want to see more proactive action. And until they see that, they're going to take their dollars elsewhere.
So the whole, I mean, because it's interesting, the analyst community comes out and defends Facebook in large part, saying that all this is a short-term risk, not a long-term risk, and that really at the end of the day, it's a duopoly, that there are so few powerful social media platforms out there that they cannot afford to pull from Facebook. You say that's not the case.
Well, you know, I do think it is in the short term that we're going to see some ramifications, because advertisers need to show that they are doing something. In the long term, I think you're absolutely right. I think the analysts are right. You know, Facebook has created this web of connections that make it very difficult for customers to pull out. And advertisers will go where the customers' eyeballs are. But they also at the same time know that they have an obligation to their customers to show that they are sensitive to what's going on with their customers and they're doing something about it. Here's what Facebook needs to do. You know, they need to increase their internal oversight. They need to extend their policies and procedures to the partners that are in the ecosystem, rather than kind of keeping them off to the side and saying, well, you know, as long as we fulfilled our obligation, we're okay. They need to understand that customers don't care about the lines between companies like that. But I think most important, and this ties into Linda's point, Facebook needs to connect with their users emotionally, understand that users don't care if you know, they're following the letter of the law. Users want to know that Facebook has their best interests in mind and that they're doing everything they can to protect their data. And until Facebook can prove that, I think there's going to be a lot of skepticism out there.
Do you think users care that much? Is the media and the politicians, are we all making a bigger deal of this than the actual Facebook user?
Well, there's a lot of pragmatism. Like I said, you know, there's a web of connections. You know, Facebook is the way we get access to all these apps. It's how we connect with people into our calendars and our scheduling and coordinating. So it makes it very difficult to delete Facebook, even though that's kind of the meme that's out there now. So I think that users are weighing, you know, the convenience and the access they get from Facebook with the concerns about privacy. In the end, I don't think we're going to see a lot of users pull out. So that's why I think that advertisers will pull out in the short term. But as Linda says, I think they're likely to come back because users will stay.
What do you think?